हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ हातिम रामपुरा वाला एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल रिवाइज SF505 एक्सटर्नल कन्फर्मेशन। इट विल बी अ क्विक रीकैप ऑफ दर एसे। इट इज़ डिवाइडेड इनटू फोर पार्ट्स, बेसिकली द मीनिंग एंड द टाइप ऑफ द एक्सटर्नल कन्फर्मेशन, एक्सटर्नल कन्फर्मेशन प्रोसीजर, देन प्रोसीजर इन स्पेशल सर्कमस्टेंसेज एंड लिमिटेड यूज ऑफ नेगेटिव कन्फर्मेशन रिक्वेस्ट। ओके, सो विल स्टार्ट विद द मीनिंग एंड द टाइप ऑफ द एक्सटर्नल कन्फर्मेशन और एविडेंस ऑब्टेंड। सो वॉट इज एक्सटर्नल कन्फर्मेशन? और एक्सटर्नल कन्फर्मेशन इज एन ऑडिट एविडेंस ऑब्टेंड एज अ डायरेक्ट रिटर्न रिस्पॉन्स टू द ऑडिटर। सो इट इज रिसीव्ड डायरेक्टली टू द ऑडिटर, इट इज अ रिस्पॉन्स डायरेक्टली टू द ऑडिटर। हेंस इट इज सेड दैट एन ऑडिट एविडेंस ऑब्टेंड एज अ डायरेक्ट रिटर्न रिस्पॉन्स टू द ऑडिटर फ्रॉम द थर्ड पार्टी इन द पेपर, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक और अदर फॉर्म। सो ऑडिट एविडेंस इज अ डायरेक्ट रिटर्न रिस्पॉन्स टू द ऑडिटर इन पेपर फ्रॉम द थर्ड पार्टी इन द पेपर, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक और अदर फॉर्म्स। ओके, देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ एक्सटर्नल कन्फर्मेशन रिक्वेस्ट, पॉजिटिव कन्फर्मेशन रिक्वेस्ट, नेगेटिव कन्फर्मेशन रिक्वेस्ट। इन पॉजिटिव द थर्ड पार्टी रिप्लाइज इवन इफ ही एग्रीज और डिसएग्रीज। इन नेगेटिव कन्फर्मेशन रिक्वेस्ट थर्ड पार्टी रिप्लाइज रिस्पॉन्ड ओनली वेन ही डिसएग्रीज विद द इन्फॉर्मेशन। ओके, विल रीड पॉजिटिव कन्फर्मेशन रिक्वेस्ट, इट इज अ रिक्वेस्ट रिक्वेस्टेड रिक्वेस्ट एक्चुअली ऑडिटर रिक्वेस्ट दैट द थर्ड पार्टी शुड रिस्पॉन्ड डायरेक्टली टू द ऑडिटर इंडिकेटिंग वेदर इट एग्रीज और डिसएग्रीज। सो इट बेसिकली रिक्वेस्ट द थर्ड पार्टीज टू रिस्पॉन्ड डायरेक्टली टू द ऑडिटर इंडिकेटिंग वेदर ही एग्रीज और डिसएग्रीज, वेदर इट एग्रीज और डिसएग्रीज विद द इन्फॉर्मेशन इन रिक्वेस्ट। और ऑडिटर कैन आस्क फॉर दी टू प्रोवाइड द रिक्वेस्टेड इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑल्सो और प्रोवाइडिंग द रिक्वेस्टेड इन्फॉर्मेशन। एंड द नेगेटिव कन्फर्मेशन रिक्वेस्ट दैट इज द रिक्वेस्ट दैट द थर्ड पार्टी शुड रिस्पॉन्ड डायरेक्टली टू द ऑडिटर ओनली इफ इट डिसएग्रीज विद द इन्फॉर्मेशन इन द रिक्वेस्ट। सो ओनली इफ इट डिसएग्री देन ही शुड रिस्पॉन्ड विद द इन्फॉर्मेशन इन द रिक्वेस्ट। देन द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इज area where the external confirmation may be obtained. So which all area where the auditor can request the external confirmation, audit evidence by external confirmation? That first is bank balance and other confirmation from the bankers, that is for obtaining the bank balance. Second, accounts receivable, account payable, stock lying with the third party, property title deed with the third party. So stock with the third party or property title deed held by the third party. Then investment purchase but delivery not taken, loans from the lenders. So confirmation of the loan balance, basically the loan closing balance. So for that auditor can request the external confirmation. So it is first is bank balance, second accounts receivable, account payable, then inventory lying at the third party, then property title deed held by the third party, and investment purchased where the delivery is not taken, then loans from the lenders or terms of an agreement or transaction with the third party. So we are done with where the external confirmation is required, that is bank balance, accounts receivable payable, stock lying, property title deed, investment purchase, loan from the lender or the terms of an agreement or the transaction with the third party. Okay, now the next concept, that is external confirmation procedure. What is the external confirmation procedure? What is the procedure basically? First, auditor have to determine the information to be confirmed. So what information auditor is required to confirm? Then he will select the appropriate third party, that is selecting appropriate third party. Then he will design the confirmation request. So first is determine the information to be confirmed, select the appropriate third party, then designing the confirmation request and sending the confirmation request including the follow-up. Then factors to be considered while designing the confirmation request. So what are factors which auditor need to take into consideration while designing the external confirmation request? So first is assertions being addressed, specific identified risk of material misstatement, presentation in the layout and presentation of the request, prior experience of an audit, methods of the communications, management authorization, and ability of the confirming party to respond directly to ability of the confirming party to provide respond. Okay, it is ability of the confirming party to provide the requested information. So what are the factors? First is assertions being addressed, specific identified risk of material misstatement, then this two are done. Then third is what we can say, layout and presentation, prior experience of an audit, modes of the methods of the communication, then what we can say, methods of communication, then it was methods. After that, okay, management authorization and ability of the confirming party to request the to provide the requested information. So we'll speak out again without seeing the factors. First was assertions being addressed, specific identified risk of material misstatement, then a presentation in the layout, prior experience with an audit, then कन्फर्मेशन व्हाट यू से मेथड्स ऑफ द कम्युनिकेशन देन मेथड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन मैनेजमेंट ऑथराइजेशन एंड एबिलिटी ऑफ द इंटरनल पार्टी टू प्रोवाइड द रिक्वेस्टेड इन्फॉर्मेशन देन विल मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज द ऑडिट प्रोसीजर इन स्पेशल सर्कमस्टेंसेज what auditor will adopt in special circumstances. So what all are the special circumstances? That is, the management refuses to send the confirmation request. So we have to send basically the confirmation request to the third party, but management is refusing the management refused to allow the auditor to send the confirmation request. So what auditor will do? First inquire the reason. First he will ask the reason for the management, then evaluate the implication on the risk of material misstatement. So he will evaluate the implication on the risk of material misstatement, and he will perform an alternate audit procedure. So now when the management responds to that inquiry, management basically gives the reasons for such a refusal. So the refusal appears to be unreasonable, or where the auditor is unable to collect audit evidence, so he has to perform alternate procedure. And if from that alternate audit procedure he is unable to collect audit evidence, so he will communicate this information to the TCWG, and he will determine the impact on the opinion. So if the reason provided by the management for the refusal is unreasonable, or if he is unable to obtain the audit evidence, so he will communicate to the TCWG and consider the impact on the opinion as well. So now, based on the response, what will be the action of an auditor? So response to external confirmation request, if that response creates a doubt, so he will obtain further evidence to clarify the doubt. If the information in the response is not reliable, so he will consider the impact on the nature, timing, and extent of an audit, other audit procedure. Then if no response has been received, then he will perform alternate audit procedure. If he is unable to collect the audit evidence, so he will determine its effect on the opinion. So see, the fourth point we had seen above as well. So if he is unable to collect the audit evidence, so he will determine the implication on the audit opinion, basically determine its effect on the opinion. Exceptions occurred, so he will investigate to determine the misstatement. So if the in response the exceptions have occurred, so he will investigate to determine the misstatement. And the last concept is, they have said that the auditor should make a limited use of the negative confirmation request, because that is, as it provides less persuasive audit evidence than the positive confirmation request, because negative confirmation provide less persuasive audit evidence than the positive confirmation request. And the last concept is that the circumstances in which the negative confirmation request may be used as a sole substantive procedure. So which all circumstances are there in which the auditor can use the negative confirmation request as a sole substantive procedure? So there are four such circumstances has been mentioned in the essay where the auditor can use negative confirmation request as the sole substantive procedure. First, the area where the low risk of material misstatement. The second area of low risk of material misstatement, the population consists of the large number of the small homogeneous account balance, expectation of low exception rate, and auditor is not aware of the circumstances that the third party will disregard the request. So we'll say without seeing what all are the circumstances in which the negative confirmation request can be used as a sole substantive procedure. First, area where the risk where there is low risk of material misstatement. Second, population consists of the large number of the small account balances, then expectations of low exception rate, and the last is auditor is unaware that the third party will disregard the information. So auditor is not aware of the circumstances that the third party disregards. So it is low risk of material misstatement, area of low risk of material misstatement, then population consists of the small item of the small number of the account, large number of the small accounts or the homogeneous accounts balances, then expectation of the low exception rate, and auditor is not aware of the circumstances that the third party will disregard the information. Okay, thank you for so we are done with this essay. Thank you for watching the video.